Today, we're here in a wheat field behind me to talk about dual-purpose wheat production, and more importantly, the time of termination of grazing in a wheat field that will be harvested for grain later. So dual-purpose wheat production is very specific to the region of the country where we are, here Kansas and south into Oklahoma and Texas as well, because here we grow winter wheat that needs to go through a period of dormancy during the winter, before it actually turns reproductive later in the spring. Now, during this period, we have a huge opportunity, which is to graze the winter wheat crop, providing a large amount of high quality, high protein forage to mostly beef cattle here in this region. It is not uncommon for different wheat varieties planted at the right time to yield more than 2,000, sometimes even 3,000 pounds of dry matter per acre, which actually turns into beef yield for cattle producers out there. Now, a few important things on dual purpose wheat systems is, of course, when we're planting it, seeding rates that we're using as well. Usually the crop is planted slightly earlier than optimum for grain yield, for grain only, mostly because we're looking for forage growth, right? But just as important as planting early is grazing initiation. We don't want to initiate that grazing before we have a good root system established, right? But again, as important, if we're wanting to make sure that we have that we do not have very steep yield penalties, is to terminate grazing at the appropriate time. Now, the appropriate time to terminate grazing is what we call first hollow stem. And first hollow stem is nothing more than when we have developing hollow stem underneath the wheat head. So right after the winter, that whenever the vernalization requirements of the plant are done, it's going to turn reproductive, and a very tiny head is going to start to develop in the bottom of those wheat stems. And the way that we check for this in a wheat pasture is actually to go out in the field, and if the field is being grazed, you want to go just outside the fence where it has not been grazed yet, because grazing will delay development of that crop a little bit. And what we want to do there is we want to dig a few wheat plants out of the ground with their root as much as possible, so you're actually getting the crown of the wheat plant sampled as well. And as we do this, we have a number of wheat plants here. We will actually find the largest tiller, so the oldest tiller of that wheat plant. We are going to cut it at the baseline, right there, just at the intersection with the root, just to clean it up a little bit. And really, with your pocket knife, what we want to do later is just slice it open from the bottom up, right? As we slice this tiller open, now we can see and try to take a look at for any potential development out there. In this case where we are here, at least the tiller that I got, we have a head that has been developing already in the very bottom of the plant, so in the crown level. However, there's really no hollow stem being developed yet, at least in this plant. It's always good to check a number of plants outside the fence, right? Just to make sure that, that we are on top of any potential development that is ongoing in that field. Now, once we have approximately the 1.5 centimeters underneath that plant, that developing head, and that corresponds roughly to the diameter of a dime, right? So if you can put a dime in between the crown and the developing head, that crop is at first hollow stem. Now, that's the optimal time to remove cattle from wheat pastures to maximize cattle growth, because they were able to harvest a large amount of biomass already without penalizing grain yield as much. Usually, if you're removing cattle by first hollow stem, we're talking about a yield penalty there of, on average, 10 to 15%, depending on seasons, right? So we're going to have a little bit of a yield drag from grazing, but you gain a lot of beef. Now, that yield drag can be quite a bit steeper than that, right? We talked about 10 to 15% on average, but it can reach as much as 1 to 5% per day if we're grazing past first hollow stem. Right, so if we have dry and hot conditions after we're removing cattle and we're grazing past first hollow stem, again, 1 to 5% per day on yield loss from grazing past first hollow stem. So this is still the best tool that we have out there to tell the best time to remove cattle from from wheat pastures. K-State Research and Extension, we have an online tool where it gives you an estimate of where an early or a late variety are for your region of the state. So that's within Kansas Maisonette. Make sure and check the website to give you an estimate. But again, going out in the field, just outside those wheat pastures, checking a few stems open is still the best way that we can make an informed decision, maximizing our forage yield as well as minimizing our grain yield losses from grazing.